Hey, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me on today's episode of Pivotal. We are here with Kristen. I hope I'm saying it right because, you know, I'm Shanna and a lot of people mess it up. So I'm used to that. She is one of the owners of Boards and Bottle in the Sonoma County. And I'm going to bring her on to talk about how she's pivoted her business due to the fun pandemic that we're dealing with. So hello, and Hi. Tell me about yourself and about your business.
Sure, thanks for having me on. Very exciting, it's definitely been crazy. I'm a Sonoma County native and born and raised here. And I went to UC Davis to get my degree in design. So that's always been just an interest for me.
Can I stop you there? You're getting fuzzy again.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Come closer.
Closer?
We're friends now.
Okay. We're really friends.
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah. I don't know. But we'll keep going because this is
okay. So anyway, I'm from Sonoma County. My husband's from Sonoma County. We have three kiddos. I went to school for design. So I just always loved that. Visual communication is what UC Davis calls it. It's kind of the fancy name for graphic design.
Okay.
And this business, Boards and Bottle, really started with just a gift for my husband. I was trying to just honestly be like cheap and thoughtful. And 5 years is the traditional gift of wood. If you do any of that, you know, 10 years, 20 years are special gifts of like metal or lace or things like that. And anyway, 5 years is the gift of wood. I have to look up all the different years.
But, I know I'm about at my 7 year anniversary, so I'll have to look that up.
Yeah, you look it up. It's fun to do. It's something like it kind of just spices it up a little bit, especially when you get to that, like, we're at 9 years this year. So when you get to that point, it's like, okay, do we have to study gifts?
Flowers.
I just want to be alone. I'll just make our family name on a wood sign, like on a piece of wood. And so I just put our last name in our computer and printed it out on the print in our printer, like just from home, and used an X-Acto knife to cut out our last name. Okay. And then it was just like a really old piece of wood. It wasn't sanded or anything. It was really rough. And anyway, it was sweet enough, and I posted it, and one of my friends really liked it and was like, oh, will you make me one? I was kind of surprised, to be honest. Like, yes? Like, are you sure you're going to make you one of these? And anyway, it got better and better. Obviously, I took extra time on hers, and then that was in 2016. Okay. And since then, like, the custom orders have just been a constant thing. So really this business kind of took off on its own in that sense. That was the first sign I ever made.
So cool. And so when did you start doing the events?
So the events started, after I'd been doing the custom signs for a couple months. A friend of mine was actually diagnosed with breast cancer, and she's good now. She's in the clear now. So that's, I always want to include that. She was diagnosed with breast cancer. They're a good family friend. They have three kids. And I thought, if I'm doing this sign thing, why can't other people? So I got together all these ladies from church. You know how churches are. Everyone gets on board. And so people, they gave me money. And then I made the signs for everybody to show up and paint. And then we gave all the money that were raised that was brought into her for her treatment.
That is a lovely story for your first, you know, party.
Okay. That's obviously where it came from. It wasn't designed to be any of this at all today, but I'm grateful for it. And it's just evolved from then. So, like, my heart is really just in the community and with that beginning anyway. So,
okay. So, obviously, I mean, how often were you doing these parties towards, you know, February 2020?
Oh gosh, so many in the books. It's just been crazy pivoting from all the events that we have scheduled, turning them into live Zooms or postponements, because we were booked like all the way through summer, and we were starting to book in into Christmas.
Oh, so a lot. Okay. So yeah, I mean, speaking of pivoting, so you had to take your business that was primarily in person or, you know, doing custom orders and pivoting to doing online. So what does that look like?
Well, the custom orders thankfully stayed the same, because that's something we always, I always offered. And I say we, I mean, I, so that was great. But as far as the events went, what we did for some wineries didn't work for all wineries or venues. But what I changed it to kind of quickly was DIY kits that you could order from my website to do at home, and as well as pick up all of your signs. Like if you bought a ticket at an event, we were just having the guests come and pick up their little package of all the, you know, like they have their sign and they have their tumbler, and I packed some paints in a cute bag, and we would have the guests come and pick up at the winery to help still support the winery. So, you know, buy their wine, pick up your sign, and then we would do a Zoom.
Wine, pick up the sign. That rhymes. I like it.
So that's kind of, we haven't been doing that for all of the events, but we did it for Mother's Day, which was really great. And then we did it with another Baldessari. But then when those, I'm not able to always do like the Zooms. And honestly, it's really nice. And I think people do enjoy it. I've had great feedback from it. But I think like there's just something about the in-person and kind of helping people with the hands-on how-to painting.
Yeah. That makes sense. Okay. So what, you know, what have you done differently on social media for all of this, or your website?
My website and social media, I've been trying to keep it current as far as, you know, you're always doing new stuff and pivoting holidays and keeping it current. So for Easter, I think that was one of the big things, first holidays when we were in quarantine.
Yep. We've had two. You know, we've had two holidays since we've been quarantined. Yes. Mother's Day and Easter.
Yes. And that, you know, so I thought, okay, like let's pivot to making DIY kits available to adults and kids, you know, with that holiday that came up. So I quickly changed my buttons on my Instagram to preview what people could buy. And then I made my landing page on my website versus a landing page of kind of a brief who we are, what we offer page that with little slides. I changed it to just the landing page where they could order everything I was talking about on Instagram to make it really easy. So if they liked the kids kit, they could just easily go to my site and click on the kids kit, click on the adult kit, or click on the get tickets link for upcoming events that we still do have coming on.
Okay. Yeah. I'm actually looking at your website right now.
Oh, good. The Spring Collective. Aww.
I like the I'm so happy to be stuck with you board. That is cute.
Yes. That's hanging downstairs. I'm like,
oh. That makes sense. And I like the little the kids do-it-yourself kits. I might have to get one of those, because I bet my little dude would love that.
Right. Well, I feel that. Like, I know how my kids are. And the kids ones are neat because they're actually, these are the ones that, if you haven't seen what I do. So you get, you arrive at the party and you have, this is the stencil. The blue part is the stencil. And then you paint in the letters.
Okay.
Right. And then it looks like, when you're done painting, it looks like that.
Oh, I see. Okay. So you have it all ready to go, and people can, very easy.
Yeah, right. So you just peel off the blue part. But for the kids, I found when my kids wanted to do it, they just wanted to paint. They just wanted to throw paint on them. So theirs are a lot easier. And the part, I just do like a unicorn, for example, or a dino, and the stencil on there. Then they can paint the whole board. And then what they do is they remove that small space. So they have more painting room versus trying to just paint in letters.
Yeah.
I just put the stencil. It's like opposite, like negative space.
Okay. That makes sense.
Yeah. So it's a little bit easier for the little hands and the wilder creativity.
That is a good way of putting messy.
Yes. Wild creativity.
I love it. So, okay. So you've had to change up your website, a little bit of your social media. Do you have an email list or any other digital tools that you've been using to kind of get the word out and connect with your audience?
You know what? I do have an email list. You can subscribe to my website, and it has just been, it's always a learning experience in small business. Every day it's always a learning experience. However, this has been, I think for all of us, honestly, quite exhausting because the information's constantly changing. You're constantly trying to make your business as easily understandable, accessible, you know, across the board. And that includes daily updates almost. So that can just be so tiring. Yeah. And I do, I have a lot of people that will message me on different platforms. So trying to keep up with that, I feel like is, I love that personal level, honestly. But yeah, I do have an email list that is for people who want to know about upcoming events or all the current events that have been postponed. That's how I'll communicate with folks that way. And then partnering with like other wineries. And I've been trying to do more like live events with wineries slash venues that I'm working with in the future too, to kind of, like you're saying, test out the water, see how it works, just trying to always find new ways to promote the other small businesses out there that are really feeling it.
Yeah, I've always loved what you, even what you did, what was it, last November with the new hotel that just opened up in Railroad Square. Yes, yeah. You did like a charity event, right?
We did.
Something where you got
a few different ones, charity events. Some were for the October fire. Well, there was two Octobers, but there was two events for that that we did. Percentage went to those affected by that. And then recently I did a She Shed event live where I would sell my signs live via Facebook, and you'd comment and you'd get that sign. And then we donated like $250 to the Redwood Empire Food Bank too.
Wow.
So yeah, definitely.
Wait, talk to me how you were doing Facebook Live. What you were, people would pay for something, pay for a board? Like so you would just hold up a board?
Or? Yeah, so I make a lot of example signs for events. So I take photos of them and people can see this is what we're painting. And those accumulate over time. And I had some holiday signs as well. And the first one happened, I call it the She Shed. Because that's where my first, I make all these signs by hand. It's all handcrafted by me. It's all designed by me here in Sonoma County. And so my girlfriend was like, this is your She Shed, you know, like all my tools and stuff.
Okay.
And so the first one I had was held where I literally did my work in my shed. And I had the signs set up and people, I just wanted to kind of go through stuff. So anyway, I've had three total. And then,
I like that idea to kind of get, so basically getting, going through your inventory.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Clearing through it and, you know, freshening it up, which I love to do. And it takes a while to accumulate it, maybe like once a year, once every 2 years or whatnot. But this last one I did it. I was actually influenced by Luma Village or Luma Vintage. I'm sorry. She's a local, she does all the cute like local Petaluma stuff.
Okay.
The local business over, and I've liked her stuff for a long time, and I just happened to catch her on Facebook doing it. And so what she was doing was holding up a product and it had a number and she'd say a price and you just commented if you want it, and some were like super cheap sale items, etc. So it inspired me to do that with this, and then I just took some of the proceeds and donated it.
It's a really good way to, you know, get rid of some products that and have that connection with people. I like the interaction that you have. It's kind of live and you're kind of exclusive. I like that. Like, get it before it's gone.
Right.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, you were mentioning before, it's you and your husband that has the business, right? It's mostly you.
Well, it's me.
It's me. It's okay.
He taught me how to, I didn't know how to use a drill when all this started. And I didn't even have a Cricut at all. I did X-Acto knife stencils on paper.
Okay.
So it's obviously silly.
It takes a while. No, I think if you're doing one at a time here and there, that'd be fine.
Right. And now it's just developed beyond anything I could have imagined. So I just kind of went for it and just kept going based on the demand. And then, you know, one winery, two wineries, you just, the more connections. And I just love this, our home so much, you know, because it seems we all kind of know each other somehow, and I just love that. Mm-hmm. He taught me how to use the tools, and then now I have a full-on wood shop.
That is so cool. Well, once we're able to have events again, do you think you'll still maybe do Zoom or like sell your products online still? Or what do you think will stay the same versus just going back to what it was before?
That's a good question. I ask myself that every day, and I don't know about the Zooms because it's just not the same. I'm grateful for them and they've been a good tool. I think the Instagram or Facebook Live She Shed event sales, yes, I think that's something to continue to do. That has a lot of potential, and people don't have to go anywhere, which is nice. People can't always make it to the She Shed events I've had in the past, so that actually works great. It actually creates, like you were saying, a little bit of excitement, like, mm-hmm. Oh, I need to get this before this person, kind of thing. It makes it fun. So I think those are something that can stay. And like, I was actually talking to my husband about this. He's like, okay, how can you scale this? He's like, you need to be on Amazon. And I'm just like, ugh. I'm like, that's huge scale. And I'd love to do that. My big dream is to have my own brick and mortar be a venue and get a wine license so I can be able to pour, have a big, barn and table, and actually have my own space to have my events. And, to do that, you really have to scale up. And I would love the opportunity to have people, like have employees that can make a large scale of my signs, because I have a pretty set size range. Mm-hmm. And all that needs to be done is just somebody needs to make like 5,000 of them for me. That'd be really great.
That I get. Yeah, that's how you're going to go on Amazon. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Hey, those are some really good goals. I'm excited for you guys. I have been following along on Instagram.
Yes.
I'm so excited about my technology. Boards and Bottle. And thank you so much for, talking about, what you've been up to and what you're going to do afterwards. Because
Absolutely.
Now I'm excited to see what happens. Yeah. And I do like that you said that you're not going to continue the Zoom, video conferencing. And so many people are not sure about that, if it's going to, stick with the virtual happy hours or virtual tastings or something like that. They're not sure mm-hmm. if they're going to keep that afterwards or not. But mm-hmm. I like just the honesty and kind of giving people permission. You don't have to. You can. Eventually, life might go back to normal. I mean, right. This is not going to live around us forever. And there will be some time where we're going to be able to be face to face and cheers together.
Yes. And it's just, it's that much, it'll be that much more sweeter. But it's true. I hear from a lot of people, like, I don't like those things. I don't want to be on them. And I think I've had really great feedback, to be honest. And like, I really enjoy being with people as well. But yeah, it's true. It's okay to not continue to do some things as well.
Yeah. So
Can I mention one more thing? I totally
absolutely
to mention it when we were talking about the fundraisers that you brought up. We have an event planned with Third Street Ale Works in June, which we've had planned for a while, and it's on the 18th. And me and Matt just talked about it the other day, how they've been doing, I don't know if you've heard about what they're doing for the community.
I know that they're doing like kind of CSA type boxes with partnering with farms or Andy's Market and stuff like that.
Right. And meats and eggs and dairy and honey. And they also did a special canning of one of their brews to help support their employees. So all the sales from that goes to their employees. Yeah, right. Like a lot of just great stuff. And so since I was already kind of doing events with them, I was talking to them, how are we going to plan around this? How are we going to promote this? So we just decided to add to the ticket price $15. And so whenever someone buys a ticket, $15 is going to go towards that employee relief fund. And then if the SIP is still in place on the 18th, I'm just going to go to Third Street and go live there and do the how-to, the Zoom.
Okay.
And if not, then, we'll see everyone there. So either way, it's like a win-win. And then I'm sure Third Street and I will go live on Instagram to kind of promote what we're doing as well.
I love it.
Wanted to throwing that out there because that's one that's coming up that people can buy tickets for and support the downtown community.
Okay, well, I will promote that. And now I feel like I need to talk to the team at 3rd Street.
Yes.
Because I know Sean, but I don't know anybody else there.
Yeah, Matt is one of the managing partners.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Well, Matt, I'll give you all that info, but Matt and Chris are the managing partners. Yeah.
Yeah, because I've written about them and I love what they're doing. So if you guys are listening, you know, check out 3rd Street Ale Works in Santa Rosa and boardsandbottle.com as well. So yeah, awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I'm excited to see what you do online.
Thank
all right.
You.
And thank you guys all for watching. You know, like and subscribe. You know, a few days ago I had one subscriber. Now I'm up to like 10. So I'm excited. This whole YouTube thing I think is going to be big.
Should order like a big one and a big zero for like 10 subscribers.
I like it. Woo! Yeah. I'm very excited. But thank you guys so much. All right. Have a great day.
Bye.